As you know, there are several different ways to traverse a binary tree. In our last videos, we looked at the in-order traversal and pre-order traversals. Today, we would be discussing the post-order traversal. If you're new to tree traversals, I would highly recommend you to check out my video on in-order traversals. That is because the basic concept behind a post-order traversal of a tree is very, very similar. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, a place where we explore the life of technology and make programming fun and easy to learn. So, here is what we're going to do today. We will take a sample binary tree and do a live demo about how the post-order traversal actually works. Then, we will also do a dry run of the code so that you can see how all of it actually works in action. So, without further ado, let's get started. Before you start understanding the post-order traversal, let us do a quick recap about the in-order and pre-order. I'm pretty sure you would quickly grasp the post-order traversal. So, when you were doing an in-order traversal, what was the order of operations? First of all, you would look at the left subtree, then the value, and then the right subtree, correct? And when you were doing a pre-order traversal, what was the order? First of all, you were looking at the value, then the left child, and then the right child, correct? Take a moment to realize what is actually happening. In the in-order traversal, the value comes at the second position, right? In a pre-order traversal, the value comes in the first position, correct? So, what are you left with? It is very natural, right? In a post-order traversal, the value will come at the third position, right? So, what you can simply say is, in a post-order traversal, first of all, you will look at the left child, then you will look at the right child, and then ultimately you will look at the value. So your order of operations would be left, right, and then the value. Now let us take up the sample tree, A plus B. So when you have to perform a post-order traversal on this tree node, what would you do? First of all, you will look at the left child, then the right, and then ultimately the value, correct? So if you have to write the post-order traversal of this tree node, that would be A, B, and then ultimately plus. And this is the basic concept behind a post-order traversal. Let us try to take this concept and apply it on a bigger sample tree. Okay, so let us take up our sample tree once again, and we will try to apply post-order traversal on this complete tree. What is the first thing that you know? You know that you have to go in the left child, then you have to look at the right child, and then ultimately you have to look at the value. So in this tree, what you have in the left? You have this entire subtree, right? So what I'm going to simply do is, I will write down this entire tree in my left column. Now, moving ahead, what do I have in my right child? I have this complete tree, right? So I will write down this entire tree in my right column. And then we have to traverse the value. We just have a single node over here, correct? So we will simply copy this value in our value column, right? Now, as you know, tree is a recursive data structure. So you need to keep applying post-order traversal until you reach a single node. You can see that you have reached a single node over here, so you can stop. But for the left tree, you still have a tree over here, right? And you can apply post-order traversal on this. When you would apply post-order traversal, once again, you will follow the same order, right? You will look at the left child, then the right child, and then ultimately the value. So the left child is 3. I will write down 3 over here. The right child is 7. So I will write down 7 over here. And the value is 8. So I will write down the value 8 in here. Now, all of these are single nodes, right? So you can stop. And this is your terminating condition. Now move ahead to your right column. Once again, in your right column, you have this complete tree. And once again, we can apply post-order traversal on it. You would go in the order left, then the right, and then ultimately value. You don't have anything on the left child, correct? So you don't write anything over here. On the right, you again have a subtree, right? So I will write down this tree in my right column. And for the value, I have the value 4. So I will simply copy down this value in my value column. Now you have reached a single node in the value. So you stop over here. But for your right part, you still have a small tree. And once again, we will apply post-order traversal on this. So on the left, you have the value 6. So I write down 6. I don't have anything on the right, so I will leave this column empty. And then I have the value 1. So I will write down this value 1. Now, as you can see, all of these nodes have reached a single value. They are not trees anymore. So if someone asks you, what is the post-order traversal of this binary tree? Then the post-order traversal would be 3, 7, 8, then 6, then 1, then 4, and then ultimately 2. Writing this in simple terms, it would be 3, 7, 8, 6, 1, 4, and 2. Now, let us do a dry run of the code and see how this is actually working in action.
On the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to implement a post-order traversal. And on the right, we are again taking our sample tree to observe how this happens. So you pass in the root as the parameter to your function, correct? Now, currently, this root is pointing at 2, right? So you want to perform a post-order traversal on a tree that has 2 as the root, right? Next, do you remember how we were stopping when we just had a single value? Similarly, in our code, we have a terminating condition. So as soon as we reach null, we will stop. Otherwise, a recursive function would keep on running forever, right? Going ahead, what do? First of all, we traverse the left node and perform a post-order traversal on the left subtree. So what would this do? It would take up this smaller tree and pass this root as a parameter to the function. As soon as this step happens, this 8 is treated as the root. And this function will try to perform a post-order traversal on this smaller tree. And as soon as it does a post-order traversal, the order would be left, right, and then the value. Correct? So this would print out 3, 7, and 8 on the screen. Now what happens is the function will go to the right part and it will perform a post-order traversal on this right subtree, right? And when it performs a post-order traversal on this part, you will get the values 6, 1, and 4. Ultimately, what you do is you print out the root value and this would print out 2 on the screen. So you can see that this post-order traversal is exactly similar to the one we did in our demo. And this is how a post-order traversal actually works. I hope I was able to simplify how you can do a post-order traversal of a binary tree. As per my final thoughts, take a moment to think and realize how this traversal technique was very similar to the in-order and pre-order traversals. This is the main benefit of recursion. Every structure looks the same. Each of these tree node is a complete mini tree in itself, right? You have a value and then you have a left and then you have a right. You can perform all three traversals on even this single tree node. This gives you the key benefit. To make yourself more confident with post-order traversals, I would highly recommend you to just take a piece of paper, draw out some sample binary trees, and try doing a post-order traversal on your own. Slowly and steadily, you will develop the pace and you will be able to do them quite quickly. And this will certainly give you more confidence. Let me know what problems did you face. Did you come up with any unique cases? Tell me everything in the comment section below and I would love to discuss all of them with you. You would be also glad to know that a text-based explanation to this content is available on the website studyalgorithms.com, a pretty handy website to help you out with your programming needs. You can find the link in the description below in case you want to check it out. As a reminder, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify programming for you. We have a lot more videos on trees coming up, so stay tuned.